Interpreting and assessing association in bivariate categorical data is an important skill, since data that we encounter in media are often categorical, like the graph shown here. Expectations for what students should know about categorical data are outlined in the Common Core State Standards for Mathematics and other college and career-ready standards documents. For example, the standard shown is from the High School Common Core State Standards for Mathematics. It states that students should summarize categorical data for two categories in two-way frequency tables, interpret relative frequencies in the context of the data, including joint, marginal, and conditional relative frequencies, recognize possible associations and trends in the data. In this video, we will demonstrate an investigation concerning association of categorical variables that aligns with the last sentence of the standard. We will continue to investigate the Titanic passengers dataset to determine whether there is an association between the passengers' gender and survival rate. First, we will construct a bar graph of one of the attributes we are interested in. To do so, click on Graph from the toolbar. Resize the graph to make it larger, and drag a variable to an axis. We chose to drag the gender attribute to the horizontal axis, though either attribute could be placed on either axis to investigate this association. We have created a bend plot. Click on the graph, and from the configuration menu at the right, which appears to be a bar graph, choose Fuse Dots into Bars. The graph has now been reconfigured into a bar graph. Note that there were about 3 times as many males as females on the Titanic, as the crew was almost entirely male. CODAP displays each case as an individual strip on the graph. To demonstrate, if I click on an individual case in the table, we will see where that case is in the graph by the highlighting of its strip. Given the large number of data cases in this set, the individual case is difficult to see. Alternatively, if I select a group of cases, all of the cases are highlighted in the graph. Students sometimes struggle to interpret individual cases within a bar graph, but this feature in CODAP helps students to make the transition from a graph where the case is clearly visible, like a bend plot, to the bar graph where individual cases are not obvious. Now, let's add counts and percents to help interpret the graph. We see that 1,731 passengers were male, which is 79% of the passengers, and 470, or 21% of the passengers, were female. Let's investigate how the survival rate may differ by gender by dragging the survived attribute into the center of the graph. The bars are reorganized so that the cases with the same value of the new attribute survived are placed together and color-coded. Note the new legend at the bottom of the graph, which tells us that the yellow cases represent those who survived, and the purple cases represent those that did not. Note that roughly the same number of males and females survived. However, there were a lot more men than women on the Titanic, as you can see from looking at the count scale, so it would be useful to compare percentages to get both the males and females on the same scale. To do this with CODAP, click on the graph, and then from the configuration menu, change the scale option to display percent. This produces a segmented bar graph. The segmented bar graph shows that the proportion of each gender who survived is much different. If we hover over the bars with our mouse, CODAP will display the conditional relative frequencies for each segment. 73.2% of the female passengers survived. However, only 21.2% of male passengers survived. Two variables are said to be associated if one variable is related in some way to the other variable. Otherwise, if the variables have no relationship to one another, they are called independent. To examine whether two categorical variables are associated, examine the conditional relative frequencies. Two categorical variables are said to be independent if the distribution of conditional relative frequencies of one variable are nearly the same for every category of the other variable. Otherwise, the variables have an association or a relationship. In this case, the attributes gender and survived have an association because the conditional relative frequencies of survival rates for the two genders are not close to one another. Females were much more likely to survive than males. Segmented bar graphs are a useful representation to analyze association of categorical variables because variables that are independent will have bars in their segmented bar graphs that look similar, whereas associated variables will look different. The Titanic data indicates that the attributes gender and survived are associated because the two bars in the graph are considerably different. In statistics, due to sampling variability, percentages may be approximately rather than exactly the same, and the two variables still will be considered independent. Students who continue to an introductory statistics class will learn about the chi-square test for independence for determining whether two categorical variables are independent or not.